Welcome to Make Something with me, David Picciuto, where every week I show you a new project or technique to make you a better woodworker. And today we're gonna make the Chevron tabletop. And whether or not you use this design in a table or a box, I'm gonna show you how to prevent blowout with seasonal changes when gluing up boards in different directions. Check it. So this is gonna have a complicated glue up. So we're going to do this in 6 different sections, working on one half of the table at a time. So the first thing we need to do is head on over to Kencraft and pick up some wood. We are back from Kencraft and we have our hickory, walnut, maple, yellow heart, and mahogany. The hickory, walnut, and maple, they're the exact same thickness. The yellow heart and the mahogany is just a little bit thicker, and I want to plane them down so everything is the same thickness for a successful glue up. We're gonna start with the chevron part of the table here. I got all my boards jointed over at the joiner, and now we're gonna cut them in here at the table saw. All right, it's time for our glue up here. We're going to do the left side of the chevron first. I did draw 45 degree angles here on the corners. That way we have the least amount of waste as possible and get the most bang for our buck. So I will make sure I will line those up. Throw these guys on there just to keep our boards aligned. There's one. We'll do the same thing with the other side. There are two assemblies, we'll let that dry. So now that the middle section is drying up, we're going to work on the ends of this table. We got our maple, mahogany, and hickory. We're going to rip them to width and then glue them up. So now that we have our centerpiece ready to go, we're going to cut the 45 degree angle and cut this edge off here. I'm going to use a speed square and line my track saw up with that and reference off of the straight edge. Oh, that came out great. Look at that. Our ends are all dry. It is time to cut the 45 down the middle and we'll split them. Again, I'm going to use the track saw. So I'm gonna throw this on here. I'm gonna square it up. We are gonna glue these guys up. We're gonna use the Festool Domino for this, which is a mortise and tenon joining machine. It's going to mortise a hole in each one of these pieces, and then there's a loose tenon that fits in there. When we glued the boards up, they became uneven. And this machine references the top edge of the pieces. So we have to plane these down so they're all the same thickness, so they'll glue together evenly. This board right here, I notice on the bottom, it wobbles. And before I can run this through the planer, I gotta get that wobble out. So I'm gonna take this over to my bench. And I'm gonna get that high spot out with a hand plane. We use my table saw as a flat surface. Now it doesn't wobble. So we can run this through the planer and we'll run all our pieces through the planer before gluing them up. So the next thing we need to do is glue up these three boards. Since we're going long grain to end grain, we have to reinforce that joint, and we're going to use these loose tenons. So we're going to use the Festool Domino to cut all these mortises, and then we're going to glue it up. So the boards are dry, we got the track saw back out, and we're going to use that to clean up one edge, and then we'll use that edge over on the table saw to make the parallel edge. So now that we have our two pieces ready, I'm going to clean up the bottoms by running it through the planer. After that, we are going to put some dominoes in here, but we're not going to glue it together. The reason we're not going to glue these two pieces together is because of the expansion and contraction with the seasons, it could potentially blow apart the chevron part. So we're just going to use the dominoes for alignment, but no glue. Then we're going to clamp it together. We're going to clean up the edges and then round the corners. Squarespace templates makes creating a powerful online identity even easier. Each template is a starting point for a wide range of projects. Whether you're pursuing your side hustle or promoting your main gig, create a beautiful website with Squarespace's all-in-one platform. There's nothing to install, upgrade, or patch ever. Squarespace provides award-winning 24/7 customer support, and it's never been easier to set up a store and sell online. Start your free trial today at squarespace.com and go to squarespace.com/make something to get 10% off your first purchase. I have a podcast with Jimmy DiResta and Bob Clegg called Making It, and we just transferred our website to Squarespace. I'm also in the process of transferring my website to Squarespace as well, and hopefully that new website will be launching in the next couple weeks. I used to be a web developer, and the reason I'm moving my website to Squarespace is because I can't stand dealing with the headaches. I won't ever have to worry about security updates and server issues ever again, and I can't wait to show you my new site. Think it, dream it, make it with Squarespace. All right, let's get back to this project and finish it up. We don't have any good blades for the jigsaw, so we're just going to use the pull saw and do a series of straight cuts. All right, all right, all right. It is now time to put on our finish. I'm using a mixture of boiled linseed oil and polyurethane, probably about a 50-50 mix. Once this dries, I will continue putting on polyurethane only, maybe three or four more coats. And the reason I'm using polyurethane is because it's very, very protective, and this is a kitchen table, and it's what it needs. Like I mentioned before, we are not gluing these two halves together because we'll have some blowout here as the wood expands and contracts with the way we have everything configured. We have those dominoes in there for alignment, but there's no glue. And on the bottom of the table, we're going to use these heavy-duty leaf locks. So it goes on each side of the table, and when you lock it together, it pulls them together. Now, I know that's not going to be very strong, and any weight on the middle will cause it to break. We're going to add an apron that goes all along the bottom of the table, and that's what the legs are going to be attached to. And that apron is going to be screwed in, probably pocket-holed into the bottom of the table, and that's going to give it plenty of strength. It's going to keep it all together, and it's going to allow for movement so we don't get any of that blowout. We are going to work on that apron and the base in a future vid. A future vid. All the different woods came from my friends at Kencraft. I'll have a link down below. I do want to say that this design was inspired by Sanford Shapes. They make skateboards and they make the coolest skateboards ever. Check out their Instagram. In my next video, we're going to show how I made the base. We got four legs and an apron and how everything is attached together. So I hope you picked up a few tips on gluing up boards in different grain directions. If you like this video, you're going to love this one and this one. As always, be safe, have fun, stay passionate, and make something.